Good morning, student. How are you? I hope you are all safe and fine in your house. Today I'm going to do a new poem with you, How to Tell Wild Animals. How to tell, just see the heading, How to Tell Wild Animals. That means, children, there are certain ways are shown in the poem through which you can tell which wild animal is that. Now let me tell you something about the poetess. She is Caroline Wells, who has written this poem. Caroline, it is written by Caroline Wells. Now let me tell you something about her life. Caroline Wells was an American poetess. She was born in Rahway, New Jersey. So she was born in Rahway in New Jersey in the United States of America. On 18th June 1862. She was born on 18th June 1862 to Anna Wells and William Wells. Her mother and father were Anna Wells and William Wells. She was married to Hadwin Hoggin. After finishing her school, she worked as a librarian for the Rahway Librarian Association. Her first book was published in 1896. So that's all about this thing. Now, children, this poem, basically there's no particular message is there in this poem. It's a humorous poem just to make people laugh, enjoy. This poem was written, but then there's a certain central idea of the poem is there. So what is that? Let's see. The poem, Caroline Wells, treats even ferocious animal and beast with a coat of gentle but weird humor. So she is treating all those wild animals like lion, tiger, bear, okay, with a coat of gentle. She is giving a gentle touch to this animal but weird humor. If you see a huge terrible beast coming to you in the eastern forest, and if you are dying when he roars, then know it is an ancient lion. The humor is created by various beasts of prey differently. The Bengal tiger is noble but eats you the moment he notices you. So children, at the same time she is praising the animal and she is telling in very humorously, she is telling what that animal will do to you. Okay. Then the leopard with prepared spots will only leap and leap again. The seemingly friendly bear hug leads to fatal result. Fatal is dangerous result, you can die also. The crocodile weeping and hyena's merry but weird smile deceive their victim. And that's why crocodile tears are the idiom. I think you know what is the meaning of crocodile tears, to shed a false tears just to fool others. Okay, generally this is very famous with the ladies. She is shedding crocodile tears to fool him. Okay, it means somebody to deceive someone. So, if you will read the poem, student, the style of the poem is humorous. There's no particular message, I told you. The style is humorous. The humorous poem suggests some dangerous way to identify wild animal. So in dangerous way, it is suggesting some wild animal. The use of words and emotion are not only humorous but ironical as well. It is ironical that the noble Bengal tiger eats you the moment he sees you. It does no good to roar with pain when you are in front of the spotted leopard. The friendly hug of the bear is deadly. The weird but merry smile of hyena and weeping of crocodile trap their victims to death. The rhyme scheme of the strangers are, I will tell you afterwards, after reading the poem only. The poet take liberties with the language to create the desired poetic effect. For example, the words leapt and leap is a third stanza are deliberately not spelled correctly to create the rhyming effect. So this you will know when I will be reading you the poem. So children, I've told about the poetess, I've told you about the central idea of the poem, I've told you about the style of the poem, And now, children, I will be telling you about the background of the poem before doing the explanation of the poem. Okay, so let's go for the background of the poem. So, children, I am going to tell you about the background of the poem. And when I will be telling you background of the poem, you all can see that there is no particular message. It is generally, it is a humorous poem. So, short summary or the background. If you go by chance, now the poetess is telling, if you go by chance to the jungle of the countries, which is lying in the eastern side. So that, because in the eastern side we find all these animals, you will see a grand and majestic wild beast. So what you will see? You will see, children, grand and majestic wild beast. Beast means animal. If in those thick forests, if you see a large and terrible animal with dark yellowish skin. Now, if you are by chance, if you happen to go to a dead forest, thick forest, and if you see a large and terrible animal with dark yellowish skin, you should be sure that he is the Asiatic lion. So, if you will go and see, because there are many people, they cannot identify the animal. So, she is giving clue also that how to identify the animal. So, if you will go to the first of all thick forest, and if you see a large and terrible animal with dark yellowish skin, you should be sure that he is the Asiatic lion. And if he roars loudly and the roar terrifies you to death, then you are hearing the roar of an Asiatic lion. So if he, that, because children, the roar of the lion is very loud. So she is telling another clue that how you will find whether that animal is an Asiatic lion or not. And if he roars loudly and the roar terrifies you to death, then you are hearing the roar of an Asiatic lion. So, first animal she has described is about Asiatic lion. What clue she has given, that if you are going to a thick forest, remember, not thin forest, not a very where there are less trees, that forest we will not never find Asiatic lion. So, if you are going to the thick forest, and if you see a large and terrible animal with dark yellowish skin, you should be sure that he is the Asiatic lion. And if he roars loudly and the roar terrifies you to death, then you are hearing the roar of an Asiatic lion. Now, if you are roaming around in the forest and you see a noble beast, and if you are roaming, suppose you happen to go to some forest and you are roaming here and there, and if you see a noble beast, you must understand that you are face to face with the Bengal tiger. And there, if you will see that yellow beast face to face, then you can see that that beast is Bengal tiger. This noble beast has black stripe over his yellowish hide. Now, children, the color of Bengal tiger, as it is told by the poem, it is of yellow color, and black stripes are there all over the body. He is quick that the moment you notice him, he will eat you at once, and he is very quick. You have to be very alert, otherwise he will eat you. This is the simple route of distinguish the Bengal tiger. So this is the way, children, if that animal will come in front of you and be very quick to eat you. So in this way, children, what you will find, that animal is a Bengal tiger. This is the simple rule of distinguishing the Bengal tiger. Now, let's see what is there in the third stanza of the poem. If you are walking leisurely, like in a very casual mood, in a very nice mood, if you are walking leisurely in the forest and view a beast, it might be a leopard. His hide is covered with dark spot. And children, suppose you are walking in a very nice manner, in a very easy manner, in a very leisurely manner, and if you come across a beast means animal, and children, his whole body is covered with dark spots. The moment he sees his prey, he pounces upon it. And the moment he sees his prey, he pounces upon it. His attack is sudden. And children, he attacks suddenly. He's not like Bengal tiger or Asiatic lion that he will be come and attack. First he will be in front of you, then he will attack. He can attack from anywhere and his attack is very sudden. There is no escape from him even if you cry with pain. And children, if suppose by chance if he attacks you and you are crying with pain, then also he will never leave you. He will continue jumping at you and start eating you before you understand that he is a leopard. And before, children, this thought will come to you that he is a leopard. So children, before that he will start eating you. So this, I think leopard is the most dangerous and wild animal. Now if you are walking around your yard, you may meet a creature there. Now children, not in the forest this time, if you are walking through your yard and you may meet a creature there, the moment he sees you, he hugs you very hard. Okay, he hugs you, he takes you in his arm, he started kissing you, he started hugging you very hard, not in very light manner but very harshly. If he does it, so you must be sure that you are hugged by a bear. So that animal must be a bear. If you have any doubt in your mind, then he will just give you another tight hug. And children, by the time you will are surprised and you will see what is happening and then what you will feel. His hug may seem friendly, but it can be fatal. It is not an easy job for an inexperienced person to distinguish beast of prey. He will be confused. So children, it is not an easy job, first of all, the poet is telling. Okay. For an inexperienced person to distinguish beast of prey, he will be confused in distinguish them. He may not be able to distinguish between a hyena and a crocodile. Hyena are very deceptive. They will attack their victims with weird smile and kill them. Crocodile pretend to be weeping before attacking and killing their victims. Okay. So it is not easy job for an inexperienced person to distinguish beast of prey. Now children, we are reading, but it is very difficult to distinguish, to identify which beast of prey it is. Especially those people who hadn't seen him even in the TV or in the books. He will be confused in distinguishing them. He may not be able to distinguish between a hyena and a crocodile. Now children, if a small child is there, and if he must have not seen the picture of hyena or crocodile, he will be very confused if these two animals will come in front of him. Hyenas are very deceptive. So these hyena are very deceptive. They will attack their victim with weird smile and kill them. So not in a very cruel way, they will smile, they will show that they are very friendly, and then they will kill you. Crocodile pretend to be weeping before attacking and killing their victim. And crocodile children, they appear to be very friendly, okay, and we will feel pity because they will be weeping, they will be crying before attacking us and killing their victims, and then they will be killing their victims. Now the last animal has been described by the poet is chameleon. Chameleon. A true chameleon is a small animal. It looks like a lizard. So children, chameleon is a reptile. I think it changes its color. If it will be there in the mud, you will see the shade has something like the mud, light brown wheatish color. If you will find the chameleon in a tree, you will see the shade of the color has its body will become green. So A true chameleon is a small animal. It looks like a lizard, and basically it looks like a lizard. It has no ears at all. It doesn't have a single wing either. So it doesn't have no ears at all. Neither it has ear, nor it has a single wing. If you see only this creature on the tree and not any other thing, you must be sure that you are seeing a chameleon. Okay, and if you will see this creature on the plant or a tree, and any other creature is not there, then you must be sure that you are seeing chameleon. Okay, so once again I revise the important point of the poem. The Asiatic lion is a grand and majestic wild beast. It is found in the jungle of the eastern countries of Asia. It is huge yellowish colored beast. It roars terribly loud, and its loud roar can terrify you to death. If you meet such a ferocious and powerful animal, you must be sure that he is the Asian lion. The Bengal tiger is a noble wild beast. The tiger has black stripe all over his yellowish hide. The moment you see him, he will not space but eat you at once. When you are strolling forth a forest, you can find a beast. And the beast which suddenly attacks you, it is a leopard. His hide is peppered with spots. There is no escape from him even if you cry in pain. He will continue pouncing on you and eat you to death. If you're walking in your yard, you can be face to face with a bear. The bear hugs you very hard. His hug is not friendly. He may press you so hard that his hug may bring you death. An inexperienced person can't distinguish beast of prey. He will not be able to distinguish a hyena from a crocodile. Okay. If you are not aware, or if you have not seen anything in the picture or a TV or a book, you cannot identify hyena from a crocodile. Hyena and crocodile have very deceptive appearances. Hyena smile merrily before attacking and killing their victim. Crocodiles pretend to be weeping before pouncing upon their prey and killing them. A true chameleon is a small animal like a lizard. He has no ears at all. Neither it has wing nor it has ears. If you see such a creature on a tree, then you are seeing a chameleon. So children, this is all and was the poem. Now I would like to read the poem, and then we will do the difficult word meaning and explanation of the poem. So I start reading the poem. If ever you should go by chance to jungles in the east. Now children, the word is used east. That means the writer want to tell you about the forest animal which live in the eastern side of the earth. And if there should to your advance a large and tawny beast, if he roars at you as you are dying, you will know it is the Asian lion. Or if sometime when roaming round, a noble wild beast greets you with black stripe on a yellow ground, just notice if he eats you. The simple rule may help you learn the Bengal tiger to discern. If strolling forth a beast you view, whose hide with spot is peppered, as soon as he has leapt on you, you will know it is the leopard. Trivel, do not put to roar with pain. He will only leap and leap again. If when you are walking round your yard, you meet a creature there who hugs on you very hard, be sure it is a bear. If you have any doubts, I guess he will give you just one more care. Though to distinguish beast of prey, a novice might nonplus. The crocodile you always may tell from the hyena does. Hyena comes with merry smile, but if the weep, they are crocodile. Now the last paragraph. A true chameleon is small, a little short of thin. He hasn't any ears at all and not a single wing. If there is nothing on the tree, is the chameleon you see. So children, I have read the poem and now I will be doing the explanation of the poem. But before doing the explanation, children, I would like to write the new word. So we will start with stanza 1. So let's start writing first. We will start from stanza 1, ever. So the first word is ever, and it means at any time. And then the second word is by chance, it means all of a sudden. By chance means all of a sudden. And then advance. Coming towards. Large, huge, tawny is brownish. Beast is animal. And dying means dying. So these are the difficult words I have written, student. So my first word is ever, at any time, by chance, all of a sudden, advance, coming towards, large, huge, tawny is brownish, something yellowish brown, you can say mustard brown. Beast means animals, and in, this is not a word, but just to give the rhyming scheme of the poem, the poet has used dying. Dying means, here it means dying. Okay, so these are some of the new words here. Now the explanation of stanza 1. So the poet is telling if ever you should go by chance, that means if at any time, if you will go to forest, all of a sudden, by chance means all of a sudden, if you have decided that you will go to a forest, you may find a brown colored huge animal too. And where you will go to the jungle in the east. So he is telling that if all of a sudden you have decided that you may go to the forest anytime when you feel like going towards the jungles which are situated in the eastern part, and if there should to you advance, and children, there if somebody will come to you, advance means coming towards you, a large and tawny beast. What is coming towards you? A very big, a very huge, a very large, tawny beast. Beast is animal and tawny is some brownish, yellowish, brown color beast. And if he roars at you as you are dying, and he will he started roaring at you, you will feel as if you are dying. If such a beast encounters you in the eastern jungle, you must be sure that he is the Asian lion. So that beast is coming in front of you. He is tawny, that means brownish, yellowish, brownish color. And children, he starts roaring. As soon as it sees you, it started roaring. Then such a beast, you can judge that it is a Asian lion. So first of all, Asian lions are found in the thick forest in the east. The Asian lions are huge, tawny beast. Tawny means brownish color or yellowish brown color. Beast means animal. When it advances towards us roaring, we feel as if we were dying, and you will know that it is the Asian lion. So what you will know? You will know that this is a Asian lion. Okay, so this is para first. Okay, once again I explain that if you ever go to the jungles, all of a suddenly you have decided at any time, all of a sudden you will want to go to a jungle towards the eastern side. Okay, and if you are advancing there, you are coming towards it, and if there should to you advance a large and tawny beast, if somebody is coming towards you, it is a tawny beast, then you can easily believe, and he is roaring in a loud manner as if you will be dying. And if such a beast encounters you, it will face you in the eastern jungle, you must be sure that is a Asian lion. So that beast is Asian lion. Now stanza 2. So I think first stanza is clear to you, and if you are having any doubt, we can do it in the online classes. Now children, stanza 2. So before explaining, you have to write the difficult word meaning. So difficult word meaning is or if sometime when roaming round is wandering. Or if sometime when roaming round, a noble wild beast greets you. Noble is grand, impressive. Grand, impressive. Beast is wild animal, greets, welcomes you. Beast is wild animal, greets is welcome you. Welcome you. Stripes is line, and notice is to see carefully. The simple rule may help you learn. The Bengal tiger is discern. Discern is recognize. Roaming round is wandering. Noble is grand or impressive. Beast is wild animal. Greed is welcome you. Stripes are line. Notice to look at you. Discern is recognize. So these are the difficult words. And student, since the time is over, the explanation of the poem I will be doing the next day. With this, I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.